So in this video, we are going to discuss dimensional analysis with combined units. And by combined unit, what I mean is that we don't just have a unit in the numerator of our starting value, we have units in both the numerator and the denominator. And the first thing that we have to know about doing dimensional analysis with combined units is how to write our given values, because we have units in both the numerator and the denominator. And there's a very specific way that I want you to start out by writing your units. And from this point forward, I'm kind of going to refer to that way of as converting our given value into math, because oftentimes these combined units are given in words, like I have written on this slide here. But if you know the words to look for, it can clue you into how to write out that given value. So let's look at a few examples. So first of all, we have 85 meters per second, and this per right here indicates that we are going to be dividing, that it's going to be one thing over another thing. So we can write that or convert that to math by taking that 85 meters, which goes on the top of our fraction, and then per means that we're going to divide, so 85 meters over per second. And if there's no given number of seconds, we're going to make the assumption that it's per 1 second. So I've gone ahead and converted that to math. So now I can see that I have two different units here. I have meters and seconds. There's no conversion from meters per second to kilometers per hour. We have to convert each of these units separately. Meters being a unit of length, ength, and seconds being a unit for time. Okay, so we converted that one to math. That looks good. 850 milligrams in 1 liter. So this in is another clue word that we are dividing. So we're going to have 850 milligrams, and I'm going to abbreviate that little mg, in, so dividing by 1 liter. 1 liter. Okay, so we converted this to math. Milligrams is a unit for mass. Liters is a unit for volume. So we're going to have to do two conversions here as well. And then last but not least, we have 75 kilojoules over 1 mole, which over is a really good clue word because that automatically tells you that you want it to be in a fraction, one thing over the other thing. So 75 kilo with a capital K, or well, not capital necessarily, but a K, kilojoules, over 1 mole. And we abbreviate mole MOL, and we will learn more about the mole later in chemistry class. So let's try an example of dimensional analysis with combined units. So this first example says convert 76 kilometers per second to meters per nanosecond. So our clue word here is this per, and that per means that we are going to have 76 kilometers divided by 1 second, and then we want to convert to meters over nanoseconds because we have that per again. So let's start out by writing our given value and unit. So we have 76 kilometers per second. And if it makes you feel better to fill in a 1 here, that's totally fine. Go ahead and fill in that 1. Okay, and to make the conversion to meters per nanosecond, I'm going to have to multiply it by conversion factor. But I'm going to go ahead and write out my target unit in math terms. So I'm trying to get to meters over nanoseconds in S. So I kind of have this up here is what I'm targeting. Okay, so I'm going to have to do more than one conversion here because there is no conversion directly between kilometers per second to meters per nanosecond, because kilometers and meters are units of length, seconds and nanoseconds are units of time. So I'm going to write myself a little list down here. I want to take this unit kilometers, and I want to convert that to meters Then I want to take my unit's seconds and convert that to nanoseconds. So each conversion factor that I use is going to make one of these conversions. So I kind of made myself a checklist here. So it doesn't matter which conversion I do first. So I'm going to just start at the top and do kilometers to meters first. So my first conversion factor is going to convert kilometers to meters. So if I want kilometers to cancel, I need to put kilometers on the opposite side of the fraction. So since it's in the numerator right now, I'm going to put kilometers in the denominator so it will cancel out. And then I need to convert to meters, so I'm going to put meters on the top of my first conversion factor. Okay, so that's one conversion factor, and I'll go back and fill in my numbers later. I need my second conversion factor. I've done this one. Now we need to convert seconds to nanoseconds. So this is maybe a little tricky. So if I want seconds to cancel, I can't put it in the denominator. If I put seconds in the denominator here, I'm going to have seconds times seconds, which will give me seconds squared. And that's not what I want. I want seconds to cancel out. So instead of putting seconds in the denominator, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it on the opposite side of the fraction in the numerator. So seconds is going to go in my numerator, so seconds will cancel out. And then I'm going to put nanoseconds in the denominator, because that's the unit that I want to keep. I'm going to have nanoseconds on the bottom in the end in my target unit. Okay, so I have seconds to nanoseconds, kilometers to meters. So now all that's left is to fill in some values and then solve my dimensional analysis problem. So I'm going to look first at meters to kilometers and decide which unit is bigger. And looking at my chart, I see that kilometers is way up at the top, so kilometers is the bigger unit, so I'm going to put a 1 there. And then I need to figure out how many meters there are in a kilometer. So I'm going to do 10 raised to some power and count between the base unit to kilometers. 1, 2, 3 steps, so 10 to the third meters in 1 kilometer. Next, I need to figure out whether seconds or nanoseconds is bigger. So nano's way down here at the bottom. Seconds is my base unit. So seconds is my bigger unit. So I'm going to put the 1 next to seconds. And then put 10 raised to some power down here. So when I'm counting between nano and micro and milli, remember those are steps of 3. So I'm going to count 3, 6, 7, 8, 9 steps. 10 to the 9th nanoseconds in 1 second. And now I just need to cancel my units, make sure I have what I'm targeting. So I notice that kilometers is in the numerator and the denominator, so those cancel out. Seconds is in the denominator and then the numerator, so those cancel out. And I'm left with meters over nanoseconds, which is indeed what I'm targeting. So I can just solve my problem now. So you can use a calculator to solve this problem. But we can also, since these are powers of 10, we can use our exponent rules. I know that if I have an exponent in the numerator divided by an exponent in the denominator, I can subtract my numerator minus my denominator. So I'm going to do 3 minus 9, which gives me negative 6. So this one cancels out, and I get a negative 6 exponent. So 76 times 10 to the negative 6th. And then this is not actually correct scientific notation. So I know that I will have to rewrite this in order to make it correct, a number between 1 and 10. So I'm going to rewrite this as 7.6 times 10 to the negative 5th power. And then finally, of course, I need to put my units on my final answer. So I'm going to take my units that are left, meters over nanoseconds. So my answer is going to have 7.6 times 10 to the negative 5th meters over nanoseconds. And that is my final answer. In our next example here, we are asked to convert 28 grams over liters to micrograms per deciliter. We're going to start by writing these things in math terms. So let's see, 28 grams, 28 grams per liter. And remember, if it doesn't tell us how many liters, then it's implied that it's a 1. And then I know I'm going to multiply by at least 1 conversion factor, so I'll go ahead and put that there. And then I need to figure out my target unit, which is micrograms per deciliter. So I'm going to go ahead and convert that into math. So remember, micro is the symbol mu, the Greek letter mu, micrograms per deciliter, meaning a small d, capital L. Okay, so this is my target unit here. So there's no direct conversion between grams per liter to micrograms per deciliter. Grams is a unit of mass, and liters is a unit of volume. So I know I'm going to have to make 2 conversion factors. So my first conversion factor, I'm going to need to take grams to the other unit of mass, which is micrograms. And then my second conversion factor, I need to take liters to deciliters. So I have my checklist here. I'm going to start by doing grams to micrograms. If I want grams to cancel, I need it to be in the denominator on the opposite side. And so I'm going to put micrograms up in the numerator. So that's my first one. My second conversion factor, if I want liters to cancel, it needs to be in the numerator. So I'll put it in the numerator and put deciliters in the denominator. Now I just need to fill in some numbers. So out of micrograms and grams, I can see that grams, the base unit, is going to be bigger. So I'm going to put 1 gram equals 10 raised to some power of micrograms. Remember, there are 3 steps between micro and milli. So I'm going to count 3, 4, 5, 6. So 10 to the 6th micrograms in 1 gram. Okay. Got our first conversion factor done. Now out of liters and deciliters, deci is below the base unit, so I'm going to have deciliters below the base unit, so my bigger unit is liters, so I'm going to have 1 liter equals some number of deciliters, and since it's only 1 step here, it's going to be 10 raised to the first power, which is just 10, so I'm going to put 1 liter over 10 deciliters. All right, so now I can cancel my units. I see grams is in the numerator and in the denominator. Those cancel out. Liters is in the denominator and in the numerator, so those cancel out. And I'm going to be left with micrograms in the numerator, deciliters in the denominator, which that is indeed what I want. So now all that's left is to solve the math for this problem, the numerical values. 28 times 10 to the 6th divided by 10. And if you put that in your calculator, you will find that that is 2.8. Let's see. 2.8 times 10 raised to the 6th power. Okay, and then my units on that answer are micrograms over deciliters. And so that is my final answer. So I'm going to box that in.